Chiefs at 3-0 take on the Lions, who are also undefeated, 2-0-1. They are. They should be 3-0.
They really should have not tied that Arizona Cardinals.
You know, a friend of the show, Adam Lefko, tweeted this morning how happy he is for Buffalo Bills fans and the Lions fans, because these are long-suffering organizations and fan bases, and I think both of their early season success is real. You know, they're pretty good teams, and the Lions are going to lose this week.
Yes. That is a fact. The question is, by how much? Right now, right. The Chiefs are only favored by 6.5 points. I would bet on the Chiefs.
You like the Chiefs here. They are 6.5 point favorites. The game has a spectacular 54.5 point over under. Puts the Chiefs at 30 points, the Lions at 24. It is always difficult to know when you can turn to Matthew Stafford as a quarterback streamer.
Yep.
Are you wearing the snapback hat this week? Is Matthew Stafford on your list of streaming candidates?
Not only am I wearing it, ooh, I am Matthew Stafford.
You're also a member.
I'm turning it around. Like, it will be a backwards facing cap in honor of Matthew Stafford. I like him a lot this week. He should have come through this last week against the Eagles, but we had TJ Dropinson letting everybody down, and I think that he's in a he's back at home. He's in the dome. I love Stafford this week.
You know, the Chiefs have really been torched by tight ends, and I know people are afraid of TJ Dropinson, the hawk strap. Since week one, you paid up, you got him, you've been super disappointed. Really hard to play him after the last couple weeks. I think he's a fine play this week. The matchup at home against Kansas City, they're going to need to throw the ball. Kansas City has not done well against tight ends. This is a Hockley's week.
Oh.
Yeah, I tend to agree with you. I think that he would be a candidate for, you know, a shot in the arm start of the week type of guy. I don't know if either of you guys picked him this week, but he's in that category. Patrick Mahomes on pace for 6,000 passing yards. So because of that fact alone,
he's
I'm going to go ahead and start him this week.
Yep.
For what it's worth, the Lions, by the way, giving up 32.5 points per game to the wide receiver position. That's 22nd in the league. We got to feel good about Watkins, Robinson, Hardman. If you've got them, you're starting them.
Yep.
They're attached to Patrick Mahomes. And maybe even more so with Damian Williams on the shelf right now. LeSean McCoy banged up. Darrell Williams, sure. I think Darrell Williams is a great play if those two guys are out. But that doesn't mean that this team doesn't put more on the back of Mahomes.
I would expect LeSean McCoy to play. They're saying that the ankle injury is minor. He had the ankle injury last week. Still played. Had a great game. He was not the workhorse. He got the touchdowns, had the better fantasy game, but you're right. It's still last week. It was Darrell Williams who had more opportunity. So this week, I think you could start Darrell Williams and LeSean McCoy.
I agree.
Assuming that Damian Williams is not yet ready to suit up.
Kerryon Johnson is our RB12 on our consensus rankings, and you can see all of our rankings use the start sit tool at thefantasyfootballers.com on the website. But Kerryon, Jason, you like him this week?
Yeah, I love him. We'll talk about him a little bit later. Obviously.
Back to the well.
I'm a big Kerryon Johnson
back
fan.
Back to the well. Wow.
This matchup is very good for him. I think he'll be fine.
Kenny Golladay, Marvin Jones, you still lean Galladay's way in this decision. Would you start both players because of the matchup and the over-under?
I would. Golladay he's locked in as the one. Marvin Jones had the big game over a hundo and a touchdown this past week. And the target share for Marvin Jones has been going up the last 2 weeks. So I think you can play Jones as a three.
It would be difficult for me to not play Marvin Jones in this matchup at home against Kansas City, where – you know, the implied team total for the Lions is still pretty good at 24. You know, he's one of those, when you're looking at a flex play, I always want my flex play to be able to have a monster game. And Marvin Jones could go out there and completely ball out like he did last week.
Oh, what a day. Oh, hey, thanks for watching that highlight clip. If you want to see the whole video, you can click down there. If you want to subscribe, you can click over there. That's about all I have for you.